check, check, check. Rob Snicker.
Well, good Friday evening, baseball fans. McNeese Baseball is back on the air on YouTube. McNeese Sports YouTube channel. Matthew Bonnet here for this evening's action, where the Cowboys will be hosting Eastern Illinois for game one of a three-game set this weekend. Game two tomorrow at 2 o'clock and game three at 1 o'clock on Sunday. It's the final non-conference weekend series before Southland Conference play gets underway next weekend right here at the Joe against Houston Baptist. Eastern Illinois coming into the ball game 11-3 overall. They've won eight straight games. The Cowboys are 10-8 and coming off a slugfest against Louisiana Lafayette on Wednesday night, just one night after defeating Columbia. We'll take a look at our starting lineups. First, for the visiting Panthers, leading off and playing center field is Lincoln Riley. Batting second at second base is Lucas DeLuca. Batting third in right field is Logan Eichhoff. Batting fourth at first base, Ryan Ignofo. Batting fifth in left field is Nathan Aide. Batting sixth at shortstop, Chris Worcester. Batting seventh at third base, Dalton Doyle. Batting eighth, catching, Ben Gallagher. And batting ninth at DH is Bryce Heyman. And on the mound for the Panthers is left-handed pitcher Trevor Nicholson. Nicholson's had an outstanding start to the season this year. He'll be making his third start tonight, fifth appearance. He's 2-0 in the year with a 0.53 ERA. 17 innings pitched. He struck out 27 batters. Opponents are hitting just 180 against him. Panthers coached by Jason Anderson. He's in his sixth season as the head coach, ninth overall with Eastern Illinois. He's got a 129 and 167 career record. Former Big Ten Pitcher of the Year for Illinois back in 2000. Also a first-team All-American that season. Drafted in the 10th round of the Major League Baseball draft by the Yankees. Made his debut for the Yankees in 2003 and spent eight seasons in the Major Leagues with the Yankees, Mets, the Indians, Phillies, and Padres. Last season, the Panthers had one of the top players in the country in Trey Sweeney, drafted by the Yankees, 20th overall pick in the first round. This year, the Panthers opened up the season at Little Rock, dropping 2 out of 3. They turned around and won 2 out of 3 against Tarleton, swept Grambling 3-0, beat Illinois, swept Alabama A&M 3-0, and coming off a 12-2 Mercy Rule win against Arkansas Pine Bluff that this past Wednesday. For the Cowboys, leading off will be Julian Gonzalez, left fielder. Batting second at DH is Josh Leslie, who will be making his debut for the Cowboys here tonight. Batting third, second base, Brad Burkell. Batting fourth behind the plate is Cade Hunter. Batting fifth in center field is Peyton Harden. In the number six hole, third baseman Cade Morris. Behind him is first baseman Peyton Johnson. Batting eighth in right field is Connor Westenberg. And batting ninth at shortstop is Reed Bork. And on the mound for the Cowboys, right-handed pitcher Grant Rogers, making his fourth start, fifth appearance. He's 2-1 on the year with a 5.31 ERA.
Boys and girls, here come the Cowboys.
Cowboys coached by Justin Hill in his ninth season with the Pokes. 242 wins coming into tonight's ballgame. 21 shy, the school record of 263. Held by the late Tony Robichaux, McNeese Sports Hall of Famer, and he will be inducted into the Louisiana Sports Hall of Fame this summer.
Defensively for the Cowboys, at first base, Peyton Johnson. At second base, Brad Burkell. At shortstop, Reed Bork. And at third base, Kate Morris. In left field, Julian Gonzalez. In center field, Peyton Harden. And in right field, Peyton Johnson. Connor Westenberg. Thank you. The catcher is Kate Hunter. And on the mound, right-hander, Brent Rogers. Starting off our ball game for the Panthers, the center fielder number 32, Lincoln Riley.
It's first pitch time. Grant Rogers on the mound, behind the plate for the Cowboys. Cade Hunter. 5:59, the official start time. And the first pitch in there by Rogers is a strike. Fast pitch outside for ball one. Riley coming in, hitting 258. A couple of home runs, four RBIs, two doubles. Scored 15 runs. The 1-1 pitch, that one's in there, strike two. Ball just misses outside. 2-2. Another gorgeous night for some baseball. We've had great nights all week. 2-2 pitch, fouled back. The 2-2 pitch by Rogers. Another foul tip back. First ever meeting between the Cowboys and the Panthers on the diamond. This one's down low, 3-2 to the leadoff batter, Lincoln Riley. The 3-2 pitch, that one's high, ball four. So the Panthers get the leadoff batter on. Brings up Lucas DeLuca.
Number one, Lucas DeLuca.
DeLuca hitting 370 on the year. Home run, 12 RBIs. The lefty. Riley at first. 3-for-3 in stolen bases on the year. First pitch high for ball one. This one's in there for strike one. DeLuca, 5'8", 175-pound junior out of Ontario, Canada. 1-1 pitch, tries to lay down a bunt. This goes foul down the third base line for strike two. Riley's at first, led off with a walk. Just the third walk delivered by Rogers this season. 20 innings pitched. 1-2 pitch, foul back, out of play. Panthers with three players in the lineup hitting better than 300. Ignafo coming in hitting 452. Counts evened up at 2-2. Strong wind blowing out of the northwest here tonight. The 2-2 pitch just was lined into right center in there for a base hit. Rounding first is Riley. He's heading to third, and he'll be in there easily. And the Panthers have runners at the corners to start this game off.
Right fielder number 5, Logan Eichel.
Logan Eichhoff at the plate, hitting 263, 10 RBIs, got 3 doubles. First pitch in there, strike 1. Just misses ball 1, so 1-1 to Eichhoff. Runners are at the corners. Riley led off with a walk. DeLuca followed with a single into right center, moving Riley to third. Here's a liner down the right field line. Making the grab on it is Westenberg. Runner tags up at third and scores, and the Panthers have a 1-0 lead.
First baseman number 7, Ryan Ignoffo.
Ryan Ignoffo leaves things up, grounded to Bork at short. Burke Kell at second, over to first, not in time. It looked like he had him at first, but ump says no. 2 down in the inning.
Left fielder number 3, Nathan Aide.
Brings up Nathan Aide, hitting 273. 2 homers, 15 RBIs. Also has a triple and 2 doubles. First pitch in there, fastball for strike 1. This one's fouled back behind us for strike 2. One nothing, Panthers, top of the first inning. The sack fly by Eichhoff. 0-2 pitch, just misses outside for ball 1. Ignoffo's at first. 1-for-1 stolen bases on the season. This one's popped up on the right side. Going to be out of play. Nathan Aide, 6'2", 195-pound senior out of Franklin, Wisconsin. Transfer from Illinois. The 1-2 pitch, that one's high for ball 2. Count is even. The 2-2, inside ball 3. And Aide works the count full. Ignoffo will take off on this pitch, 3-2, 2 outs. With the Panthers leading it 1-0. This was popped up, out of play. The 3-2 pitch, and he go around. Ump says no, and Aide walks. Brings up the shortstop. Chris Worcester, or Wooster. PA says Wooster. I got the pronunciation from the dugout. Said Worcester. So we'll go with that. First pitch high and inside for ball 1. Worcester Hill, head coach Justin Hill, coming out to the mound to talk to Rodgers. I think probably checking to make sure he's okay health-wise and then try to figure out what's going on here. Two walks, a base hit, a sack fly given up by Rodgers here in the top of the first inning. It's led to a 1-0 lead for the Panthers. So 1-0 count on Worcester. He's hitting .314, 14 RBIs, a triple, and four doubles. Runners at first and second. The 1-0 pitch is in there for strike one. Cowboys still trying to find that weekend rotation. Especially a Friday night guy. You got conference starting next weekend. The 1-1 pitch, this was fouled back for strike two. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Just misses inside for ball two. Runners on first and second. 2-2 count, two outs, top of the first. Here's the 2-2. This one's popped up. Second base, shallow infield. Burkell brings it in for out number three. Panthers get a run off of one hit. No errors and two are left. We played a half inning. Eastern Illinois leads it 1-0. The Cowboys coming up. Jillian Gonzalez, Josh Leslie, and Brad Burkell will lead things off for the Cowboys. Leslie making his debut here tonight. Was cleared by the doctors to start playing. Slugger at the Mesa Community College where he came from. Mesa College hitting nearly .400 for the year.
Starting out the bottom of the first inning for your Cowboys, the left fielder, number 27, Julian Gonzalez.
Gonzalez will lead things off, hitting .269. Two homers, 14 RBIs. He's got five doubles and a triple. Lefty versus lefty. First pitch popped up, shallow right in foul territory. Going to fall in between Ignafo and DeLuca. May chase to it. Keep Pitch by Nicholson in there for strike two. Nicholson coming in with a 2-0 record, a 0.53 ERA. Making his third start, fifth appearance. He's thrown 17 innings, allowed four runs, just one earned, three walks and 27 strikeouts. The 0-2 pitch just misses outside for ball one. Gonzalez tied for the team lead with five doubles on the year. The 1-2 inside for two and two now. Yes. 2-2, fouled back. Gonzalez has a seven-game hitting streak intact. The 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike three. Gonzalez goes down swinging for out number one in the inning.
Designated hitter number 16, Josh Leslie.
Brings up Josh Leslie. Seeing action for the first time this season. First pitch, fastball outside for ball one. Swing and a miss for strike one. 1-1, one out here in the bottom of the first. Leslie, 6 foot, 190-pound junior, swing and a miss for strike two. Out of Kenosha, Wisconsin, and Mesa Community College. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike three. Two straight strikeout swinging delivered by Nicholson. And two outs in the bottom of the first.
The second baseman, number four, Brad Burkell.
Brings up Brad Burkell. Burkell leading the team, hitting 394. Tied for the team lead with three home runs. He's got 14 RBIs. Nicholson, first pitch in the dirt for ball one. Nicholson throws out of the stretch and not a traditional windup. You don't see that too much by a starting pitcher. The 1-0 pitch, this one's popped up right in front of the Cowboys' dugout, is going to hit the top of it for strike one. One and one count to Burkell, two outs, bottom of the first. Cowboys trailing it 1-0. This was fouled back into the net for strike two. The 1-2 pitch, low and away for ball two. Nicholson's last outing against Alabama A&M through five innings. Gave up two runs, none of them earned. Two hits, walked two and struck out seven. Panthers won that game 15-2. The 2-2 pitch, that was low for ball three. He's won his last two starts. Picked up a win over Grambling, where he threw six innings. Gave up one run, not earned. Struck out 12 in that one. The 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss. And Nicholson gets Cowboys three up, three down with three straight swinging strikeouts. We played one. The Panthers lead it 1-0.
Dealership of McNeese Baseball. Lake Charles Toyota, raise your expectations.
Top of the second inning, 7-8-9 due up for the Panthers. Dalton Doyle, Ben Gallagher, and Bryce Heyman.
The second inning for Eastern Illinois, the third baseman, number 10, Dalton Doyle.
Doyle, the third baseman, hitting 262, seven RBIs. He has a double. First pitch swinging, out of play for strike one. Rogers back on the mound for the Cowboys to start the second. Drives this one to the left center field. Peyton Harden makes the grab right in front of the warning track for out number one.
The catcher, number 39, Ben Gallagher.
Brings up the catcher, Ben Gallagher. Gallagher hitting 192. He's got two RBIs. First pitch by Rogers, dribbler down the right side, out of play for strike one. The 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Ooh, look good. From here, I think Hunter thought it was good too. He's ready to throw down to first. 1-2. Just gets a piece of it. Back to the backstop. Gallagher stays alive, making his ninth start of the season. The 1-2 pitch, drive up the middle, just past a diving Bork at short, and Gallagher in with the base hit. Second hit of the game for
designated hitter number six,
the Panthers. Thank you. Bryce Heyman at the plate. First pitch, strike one. Heyman hitting 150, three RBIs, has a double. Oh-1, pitch is high. Hunter looks down to first, the runner back for ball one. Heyman, 5'7", 170-pound junior out of Michigan City, Indiana. Swing and a miss for strike two. One and two to Heyman, the designated hitter. Runner at first. Pitch, that one's outside for ball two. Grounded to Burkell at second, flips it to short. Bort drops it on the exchange. They're going to say he dropped it before. Had he dropped it on the exchange, he would have been in there safely. I mean, he would have been out. But he never had control of the baseball, so it's going to be an E6 and a fielder's choice. So runners at first and second on the error by Bork at short, trying to turn the double play. Never had control of the baseball. Top of the order is Riley. Two strikes. It's 0-2, one out, runners at first and second. Riley walked to lead off the game, eventually scored. Swing and a miss for strike three. First strikeout of the game for Rogers. Brings up DeLuca. DeLuca singled his first time up. First pitch just misses for ball one. The 1-0 pitch. Foul tips it back for strike one. One-one, high and away for ball two. Panthers with runners at first and second. The 1-2 pitch, just a bit high for ball three. So 3-1 to DeLuca. Eichhoff is on deck. Three-one, that one's high. So the bases are loaded. Third walk by Rogers in the game. Brings up Eichhoff. Hit a sack fly to right field back in the first inning.
Right fielder, Logan Eichhoff.
Rogers out of the windup. This was fouled out of play into the net for strike one.
It's all unearned anyway now.
Yeah, everything's unearned if they score.
That would have been the third out.
Yep. He'd have been unearned anyway.
He would have been unearned.
Yeah. 0-1 to Eichhoff. Rogers delivers. That one's high for ball one. One pitch. Took a little bit off that one for strike two. One and two. Two outs. Bases are loaded for the Panthers, leading it 1-0. Looking to add to it. The pitch. Grounded to Bork at short. Over to first. Bounces it. And an E6 by Bork on the throw. Two runs are going to score, and it's 3-0. Panthers.
First baseman.
So the Panthers now with runners at second and third. So E6, second error of the inning by Bork. No RBIs. Bork with the grounder. Throw over to first. Gets him this time, and that'll do it for the Panthers. They do get two runs, though. Two errors. There are two left. We head to the bottom of the second. The Panthers leading it.
Visit the table by the
3-0
for your chance to split the pot with your Cowboys. Also, fans, please return.
Bottom of the second inning, duo for the Cowboys, Cade Hunter, Peyton Harden, and Cade Morse.
The catcher, number 28, Cade Hunter.
Hunter coming in, hitting .318. Two RBIs. He's got two doubles on the season. Making just his sixth start and eighth appearance. First pitch, that was low for ball one. One oh pitch, low and away for ball two. Hunter, 6'1", 220, sophomore out of Comfort, Texas, Hill Community College. 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss for strike one. Two and one. Nicholson with delivery. This one's popped up down the right side. Going to be out of play for strike two. Hunter's got a five-game hitting streak intact. The 2-2 pitch, held off on it for ball three. Three and two count to Hunter. The leadoff batter in the bottom of the second, Nicholson. Foul tips it back. Nicholson with the 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike three. Four straight strikeouts by Nicholson to start this game. All of them
the
swinging.
Center fielder number one, Peyton Harden.
Now up is Peyton Harden hitting 361. He's got 12 RBIs. Tied for the team lead with five doubles. Second on the team with 26 hits. First pitch is high for ball one. One oh, swing and a miss, strike one. The 1-1, another swing and a miss, strike two. Harden with multiple hits and three straight games coming into tonight. That one's inside for ball one. Went 2-for-4 against ULL on Wednesday night. 3-for-3 against Columbia the night before. Leads a team with 10 multiple hit games. Fouls this one out of play down the left side. The 2-2 in the dirt for ball three. Seven-game hitting streak for Harden. Three, two. Inside, and so Harden, the first base runner for the Cowboys for the game.
The third baseman, number 8, Cade Morris.
Harden, 9-for-10 in stolen bases on the year. He's at first. Cade Morris at the plate, hitting 226. Two home runs, 9 RBIs. He also has a triple and 3 doubles. Swing and a miss to Harden. Not much of a lead for Harden at first with the left-handed pitcher. Morris, 0-1 count. Here's the pitch, swing and a miss for strike two. Peyton Johnson stands on deck. The 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike three. Five strikeouts in the game for Nicholson and six batters faced.
First baseman number 24, Peyton Johnson.
All five swinging. Brings up Peyton Johnson, hitting 263. He's got 3 home runs, 15 RBIs, 4 doubles. Seven of his 15 hits are for extra bases. Watches that one go by for strike one. Johnson, 6'1", 200-pound junior, Moss Bluff, and Sam Houston High School product. Here's the 0-1. This one's foul tip back for strike two.
Colby. Hey, I got a message. I got a DM.
Oh, and two count to Johnson, two outs. This one's in the dirt for ball one. Good stop by Gallagher behind the plate to keep that one from going behind him.
Is that an ambulance or an ice cream truck? That thing's colorful.
1-2. To Peyton Johnson, runner at first. This is batted into the Cowboys' dugout. One and two. Outside for ball two. Two outs, bottom of the second. Peyton Harden's at first. Johnson fouls this one back. Stays 2-2. Harden walked, become the first base runner for the Cowboys in the first two innings. Nicholson on the mound for the Panthers has faced six batters, struck out five of them. The 2-2 in the dirt. That one gets by Gallagher. Going to second is Harden, and he'll be in there easily with – off the wild pitch. Three and two count, two outs. Johnson with a chance to drive Harden in. Cowboys trailing it 3-0. Pitch from Nicholson, driven to first base, right through the legs of the first baseman, Ignafo. Harden's going to score, and Johnson's going to reach on an error, a fielding error by the first baseman.
Right fielder number 21, Tyler Westenberg.
So no hit for the Cowboys, but they get a run. Brings up Connor Westenberg. Westenberg still looking for his first hit of the season. 0-for-7 coming in, making just his third start. First pitch by Nicholson is a ball. And now coach from the dugout is going to come out to the mound and talk things over with Nicholson. Three errors in this game already combined. Two by the Cowboys, one by the Panthers. Connor Westenberg, 6 foot, 170-pound freshman out of Porter, Texas, and Porter High School. Westonburg at Porter High School was the Montgomery County Defensive Player of the Year and his district's Defensive Player of the Year as well. Made third-team All-State. Second-team All-Greater Houston. Swing and a miss here for strike one. Sorry, 1-1. 1-1 count, two outs. Runners at first. Cowboys got one across. Off the bat of Peyton Johnson, who's grounded to first, went through the legs. This one's fouled back for strike two. Here's the 1-2 pitch, fouled back. Westonburg stays alive. So Nicholson on the season's allowed 5 runs now, still just 1 earned. Here's the 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss for a strike three, and Nicholson strikes out the side again for the second straight inning, but the Cowboys get a run back off of an error. They leave one. We head to the third, 3-1. The Panthers with the lead. Top of the third inning. Numbers 5, 6, 7 due up for the Panthers. Nathan Aide will lead things off.
Panthers. The fielder number 3, Nathan Aide.
Aide walked his first time up. Swing and a miss. First pitch by Rogers. The 0-1 pitch, that one's in there for strike two. Yeah. 0-2 pitch, took some off of that one, strike three. Rogers, 3 pitches, 3 strikes. Out number one.
The shortstop, Chris Wooster.
Brings up Wooster, popped up to second base back in the first inning to end the inning. Rogers with the strike. 4 straight strikes now by Rogers. The 0-1, strike two. Change up there. The 0-2, swing and a miss, got him reaching for it. 6 straight strikes thrown by Rogers. Brings up Doyle, lined out to left center field his first time up, last inning. That one's low for ball one. The 1-0, just a bit outside for ball two. Umpires out behind the plate. Darren Heer at first base. Aaron Freeman at third. Rob Schlicker. Ball three. So 3-0 now to Doyle. After six straight strikes, Rogers three straight balls. That one's in there for a strike. The 3-1 pitch, this one's blasted to center field. Harden barely has to make the move and pulls it in for the out. Three up, three down in the top of the third. We go to the bottom half. Cowboys trailing it 3-1.
We'd like to thank the following partners with the folks. Navarre Auto Group, Cat Daddy's, Southwest Beverage, Visit Lake Charles, JD Bank, and Coca-Cola.
Reed Bork will lead things off for the Cowboys here in the bottom of the third inning. Facing Nicholson, who has struck out the side first two innings. Bork watches first pitch for ball one. Bork hitting 183. He's got five RBIs, a triple and two doubles on the year. The 1-0 pitch, that was low for ball two. Nicholson, six strikeouts through the first two innings. The 2-0 pitch pops this one up down third base line out in left field, and it'll bounce into the bullpen and over the wall for strike one. This is drilled to center field. Going back on it is Riley, who brings it in for the out.
Left fielder Julian Gonzalez.
That'll bring up Julian Gonzalez, top of the order. Gonzalez 0 for 1 struck out in the first inning. Since dribbled into the Cowboys dugout for strike one. That's the first out. That wasn't a strikeout by the Cowboys. Good for at least one siren a game every day. That's the second one right now. The 0-1 pitch, this was out of play for strike two. Oh, look at that. 2-22 last year, 2012. Oh, 2 in there for strike three, and Gonzalez did not like it. Looked a little bit high from here. That's the seventh K recorded by Nicholson.
The designated hitter, Josh Leslie.
I have no idea how he's going to play.
Brings up Leslie. Leslie, he struck out his first time up, making his debut here tonight. First pitch by Nicholson to Leslie. This one's fouled out of play for strike one. Two outs, bottom of the third inning. The Cowboys trail it 3-1. Two unearned runs scored by the Panthers in the top of the second. The 0-1 pitch, this one's driven to right field. It's going to be in foul territory. And making the grab near the wall is the right fielder, Eichhoff, for the third out of the inning. So the Cowboys go three up, three down. We head to the fourth. 3-1, the Panthers lead it.
Visit UA.com today to see Under Armour's full range of performance gear. All right, fans, it is last call to purchase your split in the podcast. Or it could be the catcher, Ben Gallagher.
Gallagher to lead things off for the Panthers. First pitch by Rogers out of the zone for ball one. That one's in there for a strike, 1-1. Dribble to the short, Bork up with it, and over for the out. Nice play by Bork, making the charge on that short hopper for the first out.
Designated hitter, Bryce Heyman.
Brings up Heyman. Heyman is 0-1, reaching on the fielder's choice and eventually scored. In there for strike one. We'll be back here tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Swing and a miss, strike two for game two of this series. We'll have it right here for you on McNeese Sports YouTube. The 0-2 pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. And it seems like Rogers is starting to settle in now after a shaky first inning.
Center fielder, Lincoln Ryan.
Got three strikeouts, last five batters faced. Brings up Riley, the top of the order. He's 0-1. Walked his first time up and scored and struck out in the second inning. The 1-0. Just a bit outside for ball two. There's siren number three coming by us. The 2-0. This one's hit to left field. Coming in on it is Gonzalez and Harden. And it's going to drop in between the two. In for a single. That wind, I have to believe, played with that ball. It was hit high. Looked like it would have been just a routine fly ball. But it drops in. So that's going to bring up DeLuca. He's one for one with a single and a walk. Ball two. Three hits in the game for the Panthers. They lead it 3-1. Pitch in there for a strike. Riley, 3-for-3 in stolen bases on the year. Got a decent lead. Takes off. The pitch hadn't even thrown. Spins around as Rogers and gets him easily. Wow. Riley wasn't even waiting for Rogers to make that delivery. He took off, and Rogers spins around and gets him with the caught stealing. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Panthers lead it 3-1.
Cowboy fans, if you're hungry or need a drink, be sure to visit the Trap Wells concession stand. Underneath the bleachers, right behind home plate.
Today would be a night I'd go to the Frosty Factory and watch the game again.
Yeah, I know.
I'll be home before I can.
It's the second baseman, Brad Burkell.
So what did DeLuca do?
I can't remember anything now.
DeLuca?
Yeah.
Burkell will lead things off for the Cowboys here in the bottom of the fourth.
We didn't get to the east.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. First pitch in there. By Nicholson for a strike. Burkell's 0 for 1, struck out his first time up in the first inning. Drives this one to right field into the gap. But making the grab is Eichhoff. He's made a couple of good defensive plays out there already.
Catcher, Cade Hunter.
Brings up Cade Hunter. He's 0 for 1, struck out in his first time up.
I think if they get ahead of them, they'll quit. If they can stay close, maybe they'll.
First pitch to Hunter in the dirt for ball one. ball by Burkell was nicely hit into the right center gap. But Eichhoff had a nice jump on it off the bat, had to reach out and pulled it in. The 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. He also made a play to end the third inning. Made a nice grab on a ball in foul territory out in the corner by the back wall. The 1-1 pitch, this one's hit high into right center. Eichhoff again. He's under it and makes the grab for out number two.
The center fielder, Peyton Harden.
Peyton Harden at the plate. Harden walked his first time up and scored off a fielding error. Jones away for ball one. Seven strikeouts by Nicholson in this ball game. The other four outs, three of them been made by Eichhoff in right field. This one's fouled away for strike one. 1-1. Two outs, bottom of the fourth. The Cowboys trailing at 3-1. The 1-1 pitch, that one's high and inside for ball two. Two-one pitch, high and in for ball three. So Harden looking to reach for the second straight time. Three-one delivery, high and away for ball four. So Harden gets on with a two-out walk. Harden now drawn eight walks on the year. Brings up Morris. Morris is 0 for 1, struck out swinging his first time up.
Third baseman, Cade Morris.
Panthers with a run in the first, two in the second. Cowboys get a run in the second. All three runs in the second inning, unearned runs. Harden's at first. Nice lead. Morris going to call a timeout. Harden 9 for 10, stolen bases on the year. The pitch, that one's away for ball one.
God, they have a lot of conferences for no reason. Or a no-hitter.
So Gallagher makes his way out to the pitcher's mound. 1-0 to Morris. Harden drew a two-out walk. Cowboys looking to get something going here with two outs. Harden takes off. Throw down to second. Not in time. Actually, could have been in time, but the ball is not handled. I think he would have beat it out anyway. So Harden's in there with his 10th stolen base of the season. Two balls and no strikes. So a single should score Harden. Yeah. The 2-0 pitch, swing and a miss. Oh, we've got some kind of a parade or something going on. We've got a crew, a Mardi Gras crew float passing by. A couple of them passing by and waving. The crew de noblesse. I don't know. They're a few weeks late. The 2-1, swing and a miss for strike two. I'm going to pan the camera over a little bit so y'all can see this. Off in the distance there. A couple of Mardi Gras floats passing by. Apparently that's what the sirens are for. They're heading out to pick them up. The ambulance is right behind them. The 2-2, swing and a miss for strike three. And that'll do it for the Cowboys in the bottom of the fourth inning. Leave one, still trailing at 3-1.
McNeese Athletics would like to thank the following corporate sponsors. Avon Auto Group, Beverage Sales, Dunham Price Group, Coca-Cola, and ACSW.
Never know what you're going to get.
Never.
Lucas DeLuca will lead things off for the Panthers to start the fifth inning. DeLuca was at the plate at the top of the fourth when the runner got thrown out at second on a caught stealing. One and one. Rogers with the delivery. Takes one off of that one for ball two. Rogers has walked three batters in this game. Swing and a miss. All three in the first two innings. But since he has struck out three of his last six batters he's faced. The 2-2, dribbler down the left side, foul territory. The 2-2 fouled back. The 2-2 pitch, out of play, down the right side.
It'll be done after this inning, if not during.
82 pitches thrown by Rogers. 52 strikes. The 2-2, that one's in the dirt. Check down to the third base umpire, says he didn't go. 3-2. Here's the pitch. This was fouled out of play. The 3-2 pitch. Another foul out of play down the left side.
He
DeLuca hanging tough. Another foul tip back. The pitch. This one's fouled down the right side now. Five straight foul balls by DeLuca. Three-two pitch, ball four. Fourth walk surrendered by Rogers in the game.
Right fielder.
Got to bring up Eichhoff. Eichhoff is 0 for 1, reached on an error first time up. I mean, his last time up. Hit a sac fly in the first inning. DeLuca 1 for 1 stolen bases on the season. First pitch high and away for ball one. Pitch number 90 coming up for Rogers. The 1-0. That one's high for ball two. I think we saw that pitch a couple of innings ago, and it was a strike. The 2-0. There's one in there for a strike. Swing and a miss for strike two. Two-two pitch, low and away for ball three. 3-2 count, nobody out, runner at first for the Panthers. That's DeLuca, reached on a walk. Throw over to first. DeLuca dives back in easily.
I don't get this in-game interview stuff.
I don't know why they do that. It's the middle of the game, yeah.
Maybe something at halftime if you want to do it.
Another throw over to first. I don't like it when they do it during baseball games, you know. The 3-2 pitch, this was popped up. Back behind us out of play.
Halftime on the way in.
Yeah.
I don't listen to that either.
It'd be funny to be like Sterling Gilbert interviewing during the game. Oh, we got to look at the film.
Yeah, we got to look at
another throw over to first base. Andrew Sheridan in the bullpen. The 3-2, that one's high for ball four. And that could be it for Rogers. Back-to-back walks as runners on first and second for the Panthers.
First baseman, Ryan Ignafo.
Brings up Ignafo. He's 0 for 2, reached in the first on a fielder's choice and grounded out to short. Last time up. First pitch breaks in there for strike one. No outs. The 0-1 pitch, grounded to third. Morris with it. Has to go over to first. Not in time. He hesitated. It looked like he tried to tag DeLuca on his way to third. Couldn't get him. Throw over to first. Infield sing on the bases are loaded.
Left fielder Nathan Hayde.
Four hits in the game for Cowboys going to have a pitching change with bases are loaded with no outs here in the top of the fifth inning. New pitcher for the Cowboys coming in will be Andrew Sheridan. We'll have his info here in just a little bit. Andrew Sheridan, the new pitcher for the Cowboys, 5'10", 195-pound senior, right across the bridge in Sulphur, played at LSU Eunice before coming to the Cowboys. Sheridan, no record on the season, making his sixth appearance at a 1.64 ERA, throwing 11 innings on the year. Two runs, both of them earned, six strikeouts and two walks. You'll see Nathan Aide, first pitch in there for a strike. One pitch, low for ball one. Eight is 0 for 1, struck out his last time up, walked in the first inning. This one's grounded up the middle. Sheridan knocks it down, going to home for the out. Sheridan gets tattooed by the liner, knocks it down, but he's able to compose himself, find the ball, and get the force out at home for the first out of the inning.
Shortstop.
That's a huge out. Bases are still loaded. But there's now one down, double play. Liner to Morse at third. He tags the bag for out number three in the inning. And the Cowboys get out of a bases loaded, no out jam. Andrew Sheridan comes on the mound and gets the job done.
There's your Triad Electric play of the game.
We go to the bottom of the fifth, 3-1. Cowboys trailing it. But a huge momentum swing on the defensive end for the Cowboys. Peyton Johnson to lead things off here in the bottom of the fifth inning. See if the Cowboys can capitalize on that outstanding defensive effort in the first, in top of the fifth, when Panthers loaded the bases with no outs. The Cowboys get out of it without giving up a run. The 0-1, that one's in there for strike two. Johnson is 0-for-1. He reached in the second inning with his ground ball, went right through the legs of first baseman Ignofo. Pops this one up to shallow left field. Coming in on it is Aide. He makes the grab for out number one.
Right fielder, Connor Westenberg.
Brings up Westenberg. He's 0-for-1 with a strikeout. First pitch by Nicholson and swing and a miss, strike one. Nicholson with 8 strikeouts in the game. The 0-1 pitch. Bit outside for ball one. 3 runs, 4 hits, 1 error for the Panthers. 1 run, no hits, 2 errors for the Cowboys. The 1-1 pitch. Foul tip back for strike two. One, two, that one's low for ball two. Westenberg making just his third start of the season and 8th appearance. The 2-2 drives this one to center field, but making the grab, just taking a few steps back on it, is Riley for out number two.
Shortstop Reed Borden.
I bring up Bork. He was 0-for-1, lined out to center field. His first time up. First pitch in there for strike one. Strike two. O-2 pitch. That one's outside for ball one. One and two, two outs, bottom of the fifth. Bork at the plate. Pitch, this one's lined to left field. That one's going to fall in for the first hit of the ball game for the Cowboys, and Reed Bork looking to get a two-out rally going for the Pokes. Down 3-1 in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Left fielder Julian Gonzalez.
Top of the order in Gonzalez. He's 0-for-2 with two strikeouts. First pitch low for ball one. Bork, he's good on the base path. 6-for-7 in stolen bases on the year. This one's popped up to second base, but making the play on is DeLuca for out number three. That'll do it for the Cowboys. In the bottom of the fifth, no runs. Get one hit, the first of the game, no errors, and one's left. We played five. Eastern Illinois leads it 3-1.
Make your way to the ticket booth at the front entrance.
Doyle will lead things off for the Panthers in the top of the sixth. First pitch in there by Sheridan for a strike. The 0-1. This one's lined to center field. Harden making his move on it. Can't grab it. Off the glove on the dive to the wall. And Doyle's going to round first and easy stand-up double to start this sixth inning.
The catcher, Ben Gallagher.
Yeah. Five hits in the game for the Panthers. Brings up Gallagher. Gallagher pops this one up behind us.
He is 1-for-2, singled in the second inning and scored and grounded out to short. Squares around the bunt, pops it up right in front of Hunter. Foul territory for strike two. The 0-2, that's in the dirt. Nice stop by Hunter to block it, keep it in front of him. It's Doyle's second double of the season. Pops this one up out of play. The 1-2, just a bit outside for ball two. Two-two pitch to Gallagher. Pops this one out of play. Got somebody's car.
Fine.
Hood? Right on the window.
On the window? Oh, I'm fine.
Is that yours? You over there? First time we're hitting. The 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Ball in the dirt. Hunter up with it. Over to first for the strikeout 2-3 ruling. One down.
Designated hitter, Bryce Heyman.
Brings up Heyman. Heyman is 0-for-2. Reached on a fielder's choice in the second and scored. He struck out swinging in the fourth.
Did it get the window?
First pitch, low and away for ball one.
Ah, that's no problem then. It's 10 years old. It's got a lot of dents. Let's go ahead park it there. Oh, it's got a cracked windshield already.
The 1-0 pitch, high and away for ball two.
Why don't bring the other car?
Park at your own risk over here. Especially driving down the road, drive at your own risk. The busy Common Street right down the left side. The 2-0 pitch, this one's fouled onto Common Street. Bounces some between cars. One car just slammed its brakes on, so it may have hit it.
They pull in. Yep.
Yep. Two, one pitch. That was outside for ball three.
I didn't hear any glass breaks. That's good.
No. Three, one, swing and a miss for strike two. Panthers got a run in the first and two in the second. Cowboys got a run in the bottom of the second. Panthers had the bases loaded with no outs in the fifth. And Cowboys got out of it without allowing a run. The 3-2 grounded to Burkell at second. He's up and over with it to first for out number two. As Doyle advances to third.
The center fielder, Lincoln Riley.
So two down, bottom in the top of the sixth. Brings up top of the order, Riley. Riley is 1-for-2, walked and scored, struck out, and then singled. First pitch, low and away for ball one. The 1-0, that one's high for ball two. The 2-0, liner to Morse, who snags it for out number three. And Cade Morse has made a couple of outs in the last two innings to end the inning and keep runners stranded in scoring position. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Cowboys trailing it 3-1.
Bullpen Cooking Club for providing post-game meals for the Cowboys throughout the season. For more information on joining or to donate to the Bullpen Cooking Club, visit them right down the right field line. Please welcome Lucas and Gage.
Leading off for the Cowboys.
Bottom of the sixth inning, Josh Leslie will lead things off for the Cowboys.
Josh Leslie.
The designated hitter, Leslie, is 0 for 2. Struck out swinging, flied out to right field. That was a fly out in foul territory to right field. The second time up. First pitch in there by Nicholson in for a strike. The 0-1 pitch, fastball strike two. Nicholson, 8 strikeouts on the night. He's 0-2 here. Swing and a miss for strike three. A second time he's gotten Leslie going down swinging. Brings up Burkell. He's 0 for 2. He struck out swinging the first.
Brad Burkell.
Hit a hard liner to right field where Eichhoff made a great play on it. That was for the first out of the fourth inning. This one's popped up. Shortstop. Worcester makes the grab. And out number two.
Catcher.
Cade Hunter.
Cade Hunter at the plate. He's 0 for 2. Struck out in the second. Flied out to right field. That was in the fourth inning. First pitch by Nicholson. Foul tip back, strike one. Oh, and one to the catcher, Hunter. This is fouled out of play. Might have the same car again. Strike two. It did hit that same car. If it did, somebody need to know.
Okay.
The 0-2 pitch. That one's outside for ball one. The 1-2. This was drilled to center field. Going back on it is Riley. Off the bottom of the wall. Hunter rounds first, heading into second. He'll be in there with a stand-up double. Cade Hunter with a two-out double here in the bottom of the sixth. Hunter's third double of the season. Brings up Harden. Harden has reached his first two times, both by walks. Scored in the second inning. Fastball away for ball one. The 1-0 pitch, fouled back, strike one. One and one count to Harden, two outs, bottom of the sixth. Hunter's at second. Swing and a miss for strike two. Here's the 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. Harden goes down swinging. That'll be it for the Cowboys in the bottom of the second, the sixth. They get no runs, one hit, no errors, and leave one. We go to the seventh. Eastern Illinois leads it 3-1. Top of the seventh inning, Eastern Illinois leading it 3-1.
Starting off the seventh inning for the Panthers, second baseman Lucas DeLuca.
DeLuca will start things off for the Panthers. He's 1-for-1. He's reached all three times. He's been up, singled in the first, and he walked in the second and walked in the fifth. Watches the first pitch go by, ball one. Andrew Sherrod on the mound for the Cowboys. He came in the fifth inning with the bases loaded, no outs, and got the Cowboys out of it. The 2-0 pitch, that one's in there for strike one. The 2-1 pitch inside for ball three. That one's in there. Strike two. 3-2 count to DeLuca. We're in the top of the seventh. Grounder up the middle. Burkell behind second base, not able to get the throw over to first in time. And it'll be an infield single for DeLuca, his second hit of the game.
Right fielder Logan Eichel.
Brings up Eichhoff. Eichhoff is 0 for 1. Sack fly in the first. Bunts this one. Morris with it. Couldn't get it out of his glove. And that's going to be an error on Morris. A sack, bunt, and an error. So that's a third error of the game for the Cowboys.
First baseman, Ryan Ignoffo.
So runners at first and second. Another fielding error by the Cowboys. Ignoffo at the plate. Ignoffo with a single his last time up. First pitch in there for strike one. Three errors on the board for the Cowboys. This one's popped up and deep. Infield fly rule is in play. That popped up deep second base territory, and Burkell brings it in for out number one.
Left fielder Nathan Ainge.
Nathan Ainge at the plate. Ainge is 0-for-2. He walked, struck out, and then reached on a fielder's choice. First pitch by Sheridan just misses the outside corner, ball one. Yeah. 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss for strike one. Sheridan's pitch in there for strike two. 1-2 to Ainge. Runners at first and second, one out here in the top of the seventh. This was fouled back into the net.
Illinois going to continue that fine, upstanding Big Ten tradition of somebody tanking in the first round.
The 1-2 pitch, this was lined into shallow right field, coming in on it to make the grab is Westenberg for out number two, and the runners stay where they are at first and second.
Shortstop Chris Wooster.
Brings up Wooster. He's 0-for-2, popped up to second base and first time up and then struck out. Pops this one straight up in foul territory. Hunter makes the grab right in front of the Cowboys dugout for out number three, and for the third straight inning, Cowboys strand Eastern Illinois runners in scoring position. We've reached stretch time. Cowboys looking to get something going, trailing it 3-1. Cade Morris will start things off for the Cowboys here in the bottom of the seventh inning. He's 0-for-2 with two strikeouts. But he's due to get something going here at this plate appearance. Bottom of the seventh inning. Cowboys running out of chances. First pitch high and away for ball one. Nicholson still on the mound for the Panthers. Action in the Panther bullpen heating up. The 1-0 pitch, swinging a foul tip for strike one. Hundred pitches thrown by Nicholson. The 1-1 pitch, swinging a miss for strike two. One, two, swing and a miss, strike three, and Morris goes down swinging for the third straight time tonight.
First baseman, Peyton Johnson.
Strikeout number 11 by Nicholson. Peyton Johnson looking for his first hit. He's 0-for-2, reaching on the air. Fly it out to left field. Pitches in there for strike one. The 0-1. Change up in there for strike two. And two to Johnson. This one's fouled out of play. What's he down to?
Ouch.
Nicholson's ERA down to 0.39. Giving up one unearned run here tonight. Through six and a third. The 0-2 pitch. Johnson just gets a piece of it. Westenberg is on deck. Cowboys just two hits in this ball game. The 0-2 pitch, that was high and away for ball one. One and two. Popped up out of play.
Move and he missed it.
One and two. Ted Johnson, one out. The pitch. Johnson staying alive. Fouls it back out of play again. Nobody on. One out in the bottom of the seventh. Cowboys looking to get something going here. Just one run in the game and two hits. The 1-2. That was high and inside for ball two. That one clips Johnson on his elbow, and so he'll take first, hit by pitch. That might do it for Nicholson, and we will have a pitching change for the Panthers. Nicholson pitched one heck of a ball game here tonight, went 6 1/3 innings, 11 strikeouts, one unearned run right now. He is accountable for the runner at first base. We'll get the new pitcher for the Panthers here in just a minute. New pitcher for Nichols coming in. A 0-0 record, 4.05 ERA.
Jackson Nichols.
He's making his seventh appearance on the year. 6 2/3 innings pitched. Two walks, seven strikeouts. Allowed four runs, three of them earned, six hits. Opponents are hitting .231 against him. New batter for the Cowboys, Braden Duhon, pinch hitting for Westenberg. So Duhon will try to keep things going for the Cowboys. Peyton Johnson's on first base after getting hit by a pitch. First pitch in there by Nichols for a strike. The 0-1 pitch, strike two. Oh, he got fouled. 0-2 to Duhon. Duhon the lefty. Nichols the righty. Foul tip back. Oh, 2, that one's high and away for ball one. Right. Runner at first for the Cowboys, one out, bottom of the seventh inning. Panthers leading it 3-1, game one of this three-game series. With the 1-2, foul tip back. Duhon stays alive. Game two tomorrow at 2 o'clock. We'll have it right here on McNeese Sports YouTube. Game three on Sunday at 1. This one's drilled down the left side out of play. Foul. The 1-2 breaks in there for called strike three. Duhon goes down looking.
A shortstop, Reed Bork.
Strikeout number 12 in the game for the Panther pitchers. Brings up Reed Bork. He is 1-for-2, lined out to center field in the third inning. Singled to left field in the fifth. Lines this one down the left side, out of play for strike one. Oh, he's gonna let him take it.
Oh, he blocked it.
The 0-1 pitch squared to bunt. High and away for ball one. Two and one now to Bork. Johnson's at first, hit by a pitch. We had a pitching change. There are two out. Reed Bork at the plate. 2-1 pitch inside for ball three. So a walk will get the top of the order up, plus the go-ahead run at the plate. The 3-1, grounder to second base. Fielded over to first for out number three, and the Cowboys are done in the bottom of the seventh inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and they leave one. We go to the eighth. It is 3-1. Panthers lead it.
McNeese Athletics would like to thank the following corporate sponsors, like Charles Toyota, Coca-Cola, Citgo, and Lake Charles Regional Airport.
Doyle leading things off for the Panthers in the top of the eighth inning. Doubled his last time up. Left stranded at third base. Duhon out in right field for the Cowboys. The 1-2 pitch by Sheridan just misses for ball two. The 2-2, that was low and away for ball three. Ball's in there, called strike three, and Doyle thought it was ball four. He was heading to first, and he's got some words to the umpire.
The catcher, Ben Gallagher.
Good-looking pitch by Sheridan. Out number one. Brings up Gallagher. Gallagher is one for three. First pitch is low and away for ball one. Gallagher singled in the second and scored one of two unearned runs in that inning. The 1-0 pitch, that one's in there, fastball for strike one. The 1-1, inside, ball two. The 2-1, fastball in there, strike two. Two-two? Boy, that looked good from here. Must have just been a little bit outside. 3-2. Three-two count to Gallagher. One out, the pitch. Grounded to first. Johnson has it. He'll step on the bag for the unassisted out. Two down in the inning.
Designated hitter, Bryce Heyman.
The DH Heyman at the plate. Heyman is 0 for 3. Reached on the fielder's choice in the second and then scored an unearned run. Struck out in the fourth and grounded out to second in the sixth. Watch the first pitch go by for ball one. Since fouled out of play, back onto Common Street for strike one. Two and one. The pitch, that one's high and away for ball three. Sheridan working on his third full inning of work. This one's in there for strike two. Came in with no outs, and the bases loaded in the top of the fifth. And was able to get out of the jam. The 3-2, that one's inside, catches the corner for strike three, and that'll do it. For the Panthers in the top of the eighth. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left. We go to the bottom of the eighth. The Cowboys trailing it 3-1.
left fielder, Julian Gonzalez.
Top of the order for the Cowboys to start the bottom of the eighth inning, Julian Gonzalez. Steps in, looking to get things started for this offense. It only has two hits in the game. First pitch by Nichols, off speed, up for ball one. Gonzalez is 0 for 3. Two strikeouts, popped up to shallow right. The 1-0, that was fastball in there for strike one. The 1-1 just out for ball two. That one's up for ball three. So Gonzalez looking to reach to lead off the eighth. He's up 3-1 in the count. Gonzalez will take the walk. Five-pitch walk by Nichols. Tying run to the plate in Leslie.
Designated hitter, Josh Leslie.
Leslie is 0 for 3, couple of strikeouts and flied out to right field, foul territory. Leslie making his Cowboy debut here tonight, returning from an injury. Hit, flirted with 400 while playing at Mesa Community College before transferring to McNeese. Fastball by Nichols, low and away for ball one. There'll be a visit on the mound. Action in the bullpen for the Panthers. To Leslie. That one's low and away for ball two. The 2-0. That was up and in, ball three. Rio Leslie, the pitch, taken all the way for strike one. Gonzalez is on first. Gonzo 8 for 11 stolen bases on the year. Takes off on this pitch, hit and runs in play. Grounded a short because of the hit and run, though. Took out the double play, so Gonzalez is at second. Leslie grounds out to short.
Second baseman, Brad Burkell.
That'll bring up Burkell. Burkell looking for his first hit of the night. Looking to extend that hitting streak beyond seven games. Foul tip back for strike one. Burkell's 0 for 3 with a strikeout. Line out to right field and popped up for strike two. Two down into the inning.
Catcher, Kane Hunter.
Second strikeout thrown by Nichols since coming in the game. And I think we're going to have another pitching change here for the Panthers. We'll see if there's going to be a move made to the bullpen. And there will be. Foot 4, 250-pound junior out of Benton, Pennsylvania. The closer for this Panther team, 1-0 record, a 0.00 ERA, making his seventh appearance. He's got three saves on the season, 6 3/3 innings pitched, 13 strikeouts, 4 walks. He's allowed just 2 hits, no runs. The opponents are hitting 0.95 against him. He's got a wicked-looking delivery where he reaches way back and comes straight overhand with his pitch. And looks like he has quite some velocity on that fastball. You'll see Cade Hunter. Cowboys with a runner at second.
Number 38, Zane Robbins.
Gonzalez is at second. He led off the inning with a walk. Advanced to second on the ground out by Leslie, and then Burkell struck out looking. Two outs in the inning here in the bottom of the eighth. Cowboys trailing it. 3-1. First pitch. This one's lined in the left field for the base hit. Gonzalez is rounding third. He's going to score, and Hunter with the two-out single, rounds first base, a dive back into first, he's safe. So Hunter gets the Cowboys an RBI single here in the bottom of the eighth with two outs.
Center fielder Peyton Hardin. Attention, please, running at first base for the Cowboys. Number 2, Cooper Hext.
Cooper Hext will run for Hunter at first base. Peyton Hardin at the plate. Hardin has been on twice with two walks, and he struck out his last time up. Fouls this one out of play for strike one. Cowboys with a run here in the bottom of the eighth inning with two outs. Trail it 3-2. The 0-1. This one's fouled back for strike two.
Your car after this evening's game, be sure to find a McNeese representative. Bring the shuttle at the main gate for gate-to-door service. Thank you to Golf Cars Unlimited for making shuttle service possible at all McNeese baseball games.
Yep.
Your attention, please. Now catching for the Cowboys. Number 12, Skyler Thibodeau. And leading off the top of the ninth inning for the Panthers, center fielder Lincoln Riley.
Skylar Thibodeau now behind the plate for the Cowboys. And top of the order for Eastern Illinois, Lincoln Riley will start things off. Sheridan back on the mound for the Cowboys. First pitch in there, strike one. This one breaks out for strike two. The 0-2 pitch to Riley. Fastball just misses for ball one. Top of the ninth, 3-2. The Panthers leading it. The 1-2 pitch. Look good from here, just a bit outside for ball two. Sheridan with the 2-2 delivery. Swing and a miss for strike three.
Second baseman, Lucas DeLuca.
Four strikeouts now for Sheridan. DeLuca steps in the box. DeLuca has reached all four times at the plate tonight. Two singles and two walks. Which is first pitch, strike one. The 0-1 fastball catches the corner for strike two. The 0-2 pitch, that one bounces to Thibodeau, ball one. That was a throwaway pitch. Tried to get him chasing on it. Here's the 1-2. Grounded to short. Bork with it. Scoops it. Throws it over to to Johnson at first for out number two.
Right fielder Logan Eichhoff.
Brings up Eichhoff. Reached on an error his last time up. He also walked. He's reached on an error twice tonight. He had a sack fly for an RBI in the first inning. First pitch by Sheridan in there for a strike. The 0-1 breaking ball outside. Ball one. 1-1, two outs, top of the ninth. This one's lined in through the left side in between the 56 gap for the single. It's Eichhoff's first hit of the game.
First baseman, Ryan.
Seven hits.
Ignafo.
Seven hits in the game for the Panthers. Ignafo, he has one of them, singled in the fifth. Fouls this one to the Eastern Illinois dugout for strike one. Ignafo, regional fielder's choice in the first, left stranded at second, grounded out to short in the second, singled in the fifth and was left stranded at second, and then popped up to second, infield fly. Runner goes, Thibodeau throws it down, and with a stolen base will be Eichhoff.
You call that a strike? You know, that was high.
0-2. And note they call that a ball or a strike. Looked a little high from here, but it's 0-2 regardless to Ignafo. That one's high for ball one. Eichhoff's fifth stolen base on the year. One and two to Ignafo, two outs, top of the ninth. Check swing foul over the Cowboys dugout. The 1-2 pitch fouled back into the net. Here's the pitch. That one's high for ball two. This will be Sheridan's 74th pitch coming here. 2-2 count with two outs. Breaking, couldn't get him to chase it for ball three. Ignafo, nice job on holding off on that one. A beautiful pitch by Sheridan. This is number 75. With the 3-2, grounded to second, to third. Morris up with it, over to first for the third out, and that'll do it for the Panthers in the top of the ninth. No runs, they get a hit, no errors, and they leave one. The Cowboys coming up in the bottom of the ninth, looking to walk this one off. They trail it 3-2.
Johnson.
Brings up Peyton Johnson. Johnson is 0 for 2, was hit by pitches last time up. Fastball bounces in the dirt for ball one. The 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss for strike one. Robbins searching for his fourth save of the season. The 1-1, that one's in there for strike two.
He's been a little inconsistent, but
yeah. One and two to Peyton Johnson, one out. Bottom of the ninth inning, Cowboys trailing it 3-2. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss in the dirt. Down to first base to throw. Johnson goes down swinging.
Right fielder, Braden Duhon.
Brings up Duhon. Brings up Duhon. Duhon struck out his only time up. He came in the seventh inning. Ball one. The 1-0 looked for bunt. Punches it down to third base. Line foul. One and one to Duhon, two outs here in the bottom of the ninth. Cowboys trailing it 3-2. The 1-1 pitch. This one's chopped to pitcher. Not in time. Sails over first base. Duhon is rounding first into second. And he'll reach on an error. A two-base error. And he's the tying run at second base with Reed Bork at the plate.
Reed Bork.
And we got a timeout coming up with a visit to the mound. Head coach coming out. There's nobody in the bullpen for the Panthers, so just a move for the coach to calm him down a little bit. Tying runs at second base in Duhon with Reed Bork at the plate. Bork is 1-for-3 tonight. He singled back in the fifth. A single could tie things up. Bork is the winning run at the plate. Bork the lefty. Robbins the righty. First pitch by Robbins in the dirt. It's a good stop there by Gallagher to block it, keep it in front of him. Ball one. Gonzalez, top of the order, is on deck. The 1-0 pitch, fastball, fires it in there for strike one. One and one to Bork. Two outs, runner at second. Cowboys trailing it by one. This one's fouled out of play. Strike two. Duhon is the tying run at second. Reached on an error by Robbins. Advanced to second as the ball got past the first baseman. Sailed way over his head. One and two to Bork. Two outs. Robbins with the pitch. Bounces in front of Gallagher, keeps it in front of him. Another nice block by Gallagher behind the plate for the Panthers. 2-2 count. And Robbins tried to get Bork to chase that like he did Peyton Johnson two batters ago. Bork not falling for it, though. 2-2. Robin sets, looks Duhon. Duhon takes off. Grounded to first base, making the play on it. Ignafo tags the bag, and that'll do it. The Panthers win game one of this series by a 3-2 score. Panthers three runs, seven hits, two errors. Cowboys two runs, three hits, and three errors.
The losing pitcher, Grant Rogers, is now 2-2. We'll do it again tomorrow. 2 o'clock, first pitch.
Nicholson gets the win for the Panthers. He improves to 2-0 on the year. Rogers takes the loss. He falls to 2-2. Robbins picks up save number 4. Game one of this three-game series goes to the Panthers, 3-2. We'll be back here tomorrow afternoon with game two. Beginning at 2 o'clock with the first pitch, we'll be on the air about 10 minutes before with the starting lineups and the first pitch. Once again, final here tonight at the Joe Miller Ballpark. Eastern Illinois 3 and McNeese 2. So long and have a good night.